Welcome back to CADCAM tutorial. Today we are going to learn some surfacing command in SolidWorks, and here we will make a simple door with the help of surface tool. I hope you like it. So let's see how to make this simple door with the help of surface tools. Now here let's start to create a simple car door with the help of SolidWorks surface tool. So let's start with plane. I'll choose your front plane sketch, and I'll make the front view of plane or side view of car door. So I'll start with center line. Exit. Now let me start with a line. Draw one taper line. Exit. Choose your 3-point arc. Draw one arc. The same here, draw one more arc. Do not create any relation, otherwise it is difficult to take the dimension. That's it. Okay, now the last one. Last one met with this bottom line. Exit. Now let's start to define. The top line 445 millimeter, (178 millimeter), 12 millimeter, and draw one here center line and define the angle. Keep angle 4 degrees. That's it. Now let me define this position, actual position. From here to this point, 244.5 millimeter, and the distance from this line 65 millimeter, and let me choose the fillet radius 320 millimeter. Let me define the last point 20 millimeter, (50 millimeter), 300 millimeter, and this one also keep 300 millimeter. Okay, now here create one relation. Select this point and choose here tangent. Now see, this is fully defined. Smart dimension, and let me define this angle 10 degrees. Now see, the drawing is fully defined. Now you can take this dimension. This is the side view of door. So right click on the command manager, choose your surface, go to surface and select extruded surface. Now it's time to extrude, so I'll extrude up to 600 millimeter. See here, and no need anything else, select OK. So this is the extrude command of surface. Now see, now I want to make this shape in particular a door shape, so let me choose here right plane, a sketch normal, and let me define the plane and everything. Center line, I'll draw from here to this point and up to this point. Exit. Now this is the construction line. Let me define, choose line here, draw one line. Exit. 3-point arc, connect from here to this point. Okay, choose line, connect up to this point. Again exit. Now, okay, let me choose here line. Exit. Select here 3-point arc and connect this. Exit. Now let me start to define. Select these 2 points. Make relation vertical. That's it. Center line. I'll draw one horizontal line and I'll choose one more center line. Let me define this angle. degree. Now select this line and this point. 240 millimeter. This is the distance we are going to define. Let me choose the angle 9 degree. Now select this angle 45 degree. Now select this line and this point and see 480 millimeter. The same, select this line and this point 270 millimeter. What else? Balance, select this point and the end point 500 millimeter. Okay, now here's this 2 points, 360 millimeter. Now let me check what else. Balance here, we define this all points. This one also 240 millimeter. This radius 500 millimeter. Now see, it is perfectly. Now choose this one, radius 1110 millimeter or 1110 millimeter. Now see, drawing is fully defined. I hope you note down all the dimensions carefully. Now just go to surface and select here trim surface. Now we selected this sketch 2 selected. Now remove selection. I'll select this face and this face. Now see, this outer edge going to trim and the mini center one will be balanced. Keep standard and keep natural. Here also remove selection only. Okay, now see, but we forget to add some corner fillet. So again just click sketch, edit sketch, normal sketch, select fillet. First keep 10 millimeter and select this 2 corners. Okay, now 130 millimeter. See this corner. Okay, 42 millimeter and select this corner. Okay. Okay, now select OK. Now see, it is trimmed. See, now we will make the hole for windows. So select this face or let me choose some fillet. Three millimeter and let me choose this 2 inside edges. Okay, see, So this is the surface body, simple surface body. Select this face, sketch normal. One more time. Now here we will make window cutouts. So I'll choose this outer edge, convert entity, or no need convert, just select offset entity, reverse direction, see 10 millimeter. Okay, select here line. Exit. Choose the line. Here see we created one relation. Okay. One more line. Now let's define. Select this outer edge line parallel. Here also select this line in outer edge. Parallel relation. Now select this line horizontal. Okay. Now here select this point and this line coincide. Smart dimension, and let me define. Millimeter. Any dimension you can keep, 28 millimeter, and the distance from here to top point 165 millimeter. Distance between these two lines 10 millimeter, and one more distance from here to this point 240 millimeter. Okay, choose trim entity, power trim, and trim these portions. Okay, now this is the actual our dimensions. If you see, it is it shows under defined. We don't need to define any other things, just click simply fully defined, calculate. Okay, now this is a roughly calculated dimension they took, but we already took our required dimension, which is sufficient for us. Fill it. I'll keep 8 millimeter and select these two corners. Okay. Select 5 millimeter. Cancel it. These two other keep as it is. Now go to surface and here choose trim surface. Now again we came trim type standard, sketch we already selected, and remove selection. So I'll select these two faces. See, it's going to remove from this geometry. Keep natural. Okay. Now see, it is trimmed. Now again select this face sketch. Now select all the sharp or corner edges. Convert entity, the same in opposite direction or side. Convert entity. Now we want to extrude it, so simply just go to surface, extrude surface, and we want to extrude up to, let's say, 6 millimeter. And select here end cap. See? Okay. Now select fillet. I'll choose this 3 millimeter, let me say 5 millimeter. 5 millimeter cover big area, so 3 millimeter is sufficient. Okay. Now again choose this surface sketch, convert entity. Now this one we want to trim, so I'll choose again the same trim surface. I'll select this surface here. Remove selection sketch. Okay. Now see. Select first fillet. Let me corner see 3 mm fillet we are going to add. Okay. Now again select the same surface. Sketch. Convert entity. See the borders are converted, the border lines. Surface. Trim surface. Let me choose this surface. See standard sketch and trim surface. Remove selection. Okay. Now see. If you will go backside, you will see the edge. How it's going to. Fillet. 10 mm and I'll choose. Let's keep 40 mm. Okay. That's it. Now the door is almost ready. Let me add some material. Let's add some metallic gold or some color like metallic color appearance. Or even you can directly choose color yellow and make it little darker side. So select here. Okay. Now it's time to add thickness, but before adding thickness there are 3 number of parts. So first we need to merge all the things. Select knit. Here we want to make select first body. Now see inside. This is the second thing, this is the third thing. So these 3 features we are going to merge. Okay. That's it. Now it's time to add thickness. Two millimeter, I'll choose this body. Now you can see the thickness. See here thickness. Actually we took the color, that's why. Let me okay. Now let's add thickness. Select the body, 2 mm thickness, and here we have option side to both side, and you can say side 1. So it's going to which direction? It's going to, I think, bottom. Select OK. Now see, it is 2 mm thick. Now see. Now here again we will do some little modification so that it help us a lot. This extrude surface, edit. Now let's make fillet. Twenty millimeter. Okay. Now see, if we took 20 mm, it's see the taper. Even if you can take more, 40 mm. Okay. Now see. now let's add those color. Okay, so this is the simple surface tutorial. We use some few commands of like knit surface and few commands which help us to make a simple door. Let me add some three millimeter. Okay, now this fillets we are going to add. Okay, now see, this is a simple door with the help of surfacing command. I hope you like it. Don't forget to share and like our video. If you have any comment, just write down below. I'll try to answer each and every question. Thanks for watching.